not all fun.
Yeah, but that's what he's doing today. He's
plays F-15 in cool.
What is that five?
Oh, is that the P-30 light? P-38? Did it go up? It was lighting on the wrong way. I can't see it on the video camera. Oh, wait. No, I can't see it.
Yeah. P-38. It's a backflip. Jeez!
I love the zoom on this camera. Another backflip.
Inverted right now.
Oh crap!
Oh, that's sick. He finished it off, bro.
Damn.
Did half.
He's doing a Cuban 8.
Yeah. That's so hot. He's so hot about that.
I know. Maybe.
What do they attach on here?
I think this is extra fuel. No, it's extra fuel, I think. Like, you can put, like, a thing on it. Yeah. There's, like, three different versions of the L-39.
So what is this?
I think it's an L-39. It's like a trainer jet, kind of. God, look how small the elevator is. Oh, that's kind of scary.
The other NATO countries. Yeah.
The wings are so tiny.
So what is that one?
I think these are all L-39s, so different.
Oh.
That one looks like it has a different rudder, though. Color rudder. God, it's a little tiny. It's so little. The cockpit is cool though.
There's like five.
Oh god, I hear a chopper.
How many engines it has?
It only has one engine, but.
But no, it's a whole bunch of engines.
Yeah, it's a radio.
That's how much they needed.
Oh god, look it. I see like heat waves.
What's going on over there?
Oh god, fire. Oh, it's the truck. We gotta go see it.
What?
It's the jet truck, Dad. We have to go see. We'll see the. I think there's both.
Yeah. There's a green one over there.
That P-51 is cool. Okay. Another biplane. Look at a grasshopper.
World War I biplane. It's like the one in Indiana Jones.
No, it's a PT-17 Stearman. Stearman!
Do it, Tanner. Looks like the one in Indiana Jones.
Yeah. It's a super Stearman. Big prop. Grasshopper. Oh my god! That's cool. Grasshopper is so little. Yeah, it's an L6 grasshopper. Yeah, I know. It's an L6 grasshopper.
How
How could it not have suspension?
It does. Yeah. Oh god. Whoa.
That's cool.
Experimental. It's experimental.
Yeah.
The gear in there.
Oh, it hurt.
What hurt? Come over. Look at it. It's all suspension. It's got the shocks, the wing struts, and everything. I want to sit in that. Come on. God. Oh, Piper Toad. Soccer game, Neil. Oh my god. God, it's so chubby.
Oh my god, he's like doing barrel turns.
And he did it now. So big.
The cargo aircraft of the United States Army Air Force of the American Forces.
I think he's probably
going way back to 1942.
Where are all these mini planes?
Before that, with the C-47.
C-47. That's what my grandpa flew.
Really?
That's sick.
Have the C-54.
He's still trying to turn. He can turn on a dime.
Yeah, like, okay.
We're like 500 billion.
I think we need to go right there. We should go on the second
spy plane using a block.
You guys
want to
go on there?
Oh, yeah, we can go in it. Okay.
There's a line right here.
All right, we're going to go in it.
C-5B Galaxy. But these airplane systems are so advanced.
Maybe a little fast. Or touch and go.
Going slow for photos, huh?
Yeah. That's probably the top speed.
No, they can go so fast.
Really?
They have jet engines.
Needs to change a tire. Each tire can be
get hard.
Make changing a tire
a little fast, eh? Going slow. It's going so slow. Do an inverted takeoff.
Such a good flyer.
Everybody, this is Green Air.
Another T-28. There's a C-5 from Travis Circus. God.
I like that.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. Green T-28. Not something to see too often.
Oh, look at the rockets it's got.
Oh, what the? It's like modded.
It's got rockets on the wing. I've never seen that before.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
Whoa.
Oh.
Yeah, I know.
What they got there is 7 rounds.
Whoa, it's like whistling. Hear that? The wind was like traveling through the engine. Whistling. like cockpit up there.
Wires everywhere. Some people jump out of here too.
Yeah. They drop back. Care packages out with that. It's called seats along the side too.
They have a lot of birds.
Yeah.
Oh, it's really chill. It'd be so scary to fly in this.
That'd be pretty fun.
It'd be fun, but like...
It'd be fun to just like sit on the
yeah,
side.
It's like a house in here.
I know. It'd be fun to like, while you're flying, just be like walking around in here. It's like a tunnel. I don't know what's out there now.
Driving out.
Get ready. Here comes the jump.
Oh, helicopter.
Oh, that's the helicopter with the little face on it.
Incorrect.
I want to see the face.
What is it?
It's so chubby looking. I want to zoom in and see if I can see the face on it. Ah, it's too hard to see. Go on, Verdi. Go on, Verdi.
Oh, that's sketchy.
God,
that'd be such a good helicopter pilot.
Whoa. Look at the tail.
Oh my god.
Your rudder is a little untrue. I want to go in that EPS.
Is that 737? Oh, what? The wind's making the turbo.
Yeah, I know. I saw that. Whoa.
Foamy FKU.
What?
They had little foamy FKU too. It's cool.
Helicopter, so funny. God. It's like sideways. Whoa, can we go inside that one? Can we go inside this one?
737?
Yeah, I think so. Looks like one. Or it might be the small version of a 757. It's like, sorry, I had to get home. So sorry.
I'll get a broken pothole.
Yeah.
I want to find out where these guys have those foam F-22.
Yeah.
What?
What?
The balloon is on the front of it.
I did say 8 o'clock, but I never.
That's so cool.
Let's try getting up closer.
Well, they could have been 86, but they painted it to look like a baby.
Yeah.
Hey, that's a gimp. God. They would help. Oh, there's six of them. What, there's more? There's another one taking off.
There's another one taking off?
Yeah, two. God.
What the heck?
So many.
Oh, they got the bombs.
Oh, yeah.
You can see the bombs.
There's eight of them. There's 8 zeros up there.
Here comes the zeros. Look at them over there.
Oh, yeah.
Good job, guys.
It'd be fun to sit in here. It'd be fun to sit in there while they're flying. ATR 42. Yeah.
That explains.
Whoa. Yeah, they're rolling. Whoa, Neil, look at the cockpit. That's cool.
Cog. All the instruments.
They
have
men
standing on the sides
back
saying,
yeah, and roll it on in.
Okay. I'm gonna go under it like Joey did. Underneath the 757. Pretty cool. I'm gonna go in this engine. Whoa! That's crazy. God, those blades are shut. Right,
like
757 engine.
Yeah.
It's so big.
God, it's so big. Fluffy. Achilles. It's got the
ice
triple
cube.
That's
run, come on, run, run, run.
Japanese Zero's coming in.
Oh, God.
into the top belly of that aircraft of that Arizona. 1,150 minutes. Went to the bottom of the Arizona. They sleep there today. No, it can't even be 5NK.
No, because he has wheel pants, so. God, that green one is sick. How it's all glass, like.
Got the old Old Glory.
Yeah.
When they made the movie after.
Yeah. I want to see that other piece.
That
one looks quite good. It has the yellow.
Tell your dad. He's over there.
So cool.
So
Sorry. Didn't see it.
Oh, so
yeah, we're gonna go see the P-51.
That's where Joey's micro. That's Joey's micro.
Yeah, Joey's micro.
Oh, yeah.
That zero needs to calm down over there.
Yeah.
Giant yak inside of here. Oh, there's a T-28 up there. Looks like a park zone.
What
like
the?
Different wheels.
Yeah.
That's it. Dude, your micro's on steroids.
Yeah.
I hope there's a...
What is this? Is it
P-51? No, it looks like a P-40 Warthog, but messed
that's
up.
Weird.
Chad, there's two complete enemies.
That's like a mix of a T-28 and a GB. Totally.
No, that's.
That's totally one.
Oh, what is that? I know it.
Oh my god, look at that little boy.
Chad, two enemies right there. Two P-51s and two there. Zeros.
Yeah.
Facing
each other like
they're like, oh yeah, well, I got my flaps down so I can beat you.
Oh, these two.
Those are F6Fs I think, but one of them looks really short.
Well, one's got a four blade and one of them's got a three blade.
Well, I know the far right one is an F6F. I don't know what that.
Alright,
I think I think it's like an F.
Fail, guys. Jackson was
it's
just
an
little.
F8F Bearcat. You're supposed to do that. Are you kidding?
Yeah,
it's got some rockets.
Oh, no.
Imagine
if that thing's like... Whoa.
What
do you think? There's the line to the cockpit.
Huh?
Yeah.
17.
Oh, look at it.
Where did she exit? Or walk away from the door?
God, that would be scary. These are like where the people sit. Yeah, it's dark in here. Can't see it. See it. It's pretty comfortable. This was made by Boeing. God, I'd be so terrified. But just like.
And of course, this is safe.
I told you it was loud. God, it's a burner. Look at the afterburner.
Oh!
Freaking fire coming out of them.
God, it must suck for the people up there.
Yeah. And dogs who can't plug their ears.
Not everybody has ears like you, Tim.
Down and burning.
drop out of the sky.
Gosh, that was a bit crazy. I want them to do that heritage pass again. That was so cool. Oh yeah, they don't have any A-10s here. That was cool last time.
They had A-10 Warhawks?
Yeah. That was heck of zoomed in full, or I was till I lost them.
Oh man.
Hello. So cool. Oh!
Ones over there, the blue one, the tan one, and the...
Behind it. We're keeping an eye out here for the U2 spy plane, see if it's going to be coming through as well.
I hope it goes well.
It's like way up there.
Where is it? We're up there. How do they...
I don't get how it's limited to those four T-38s, the U-2 spy plane not flying today. What? Outboard and just a little bit below the leader.
Look.
Now as they reach show center, I believe we're going to see them pitch up to land. Three, break, ready, now. Four, break, ready, now. Now this separates all four airplanes. They will work their way into the downwind or with the wind, get slowed down, lower the landing gear, extend the flaps. Extending the flaps increases the wing area, changes the shape of the wing to get more lift at slow speeds. They will then turn in an oval, going through the base part of the turn, 90 degrees from the runway.
Whoa, I saw his
and then line up for final approach on
no, the fourth one.
The runway on runway 22. Lieutenant Colonel Santini Smith, Major Bog Bartrand, Lieutenant Colonel Kuma McLeod, and Lieutenant Colonel Cliffy Clevenna.
Oh, there's the Patriots. Way, way out there. Oh, yeah.
We expect the T-38 Talon to still be in use well past.
Where's the other?
We're just a couple of minutes away from the Patriots jet team, and I don't want you to miss this. These airplanes that the Patriots are flying are Cold War trophies. Built in the Czech Republic, they were used as the Warsaw.
It looks
making
like that.
Slot pilot
this.
As well.
Of course.
Flying on the outer left wing is Patriot 5, Randy Howler Howe. Team owner and creator.
God,
Howler's
so
retired
far
retired
away.
Captain, holding thousands of hours in all sorts of experience from
hey,
the flight
to
Jimmy Hatchell, L-39.
L-39, okay.
Delta is our opposing solo in Patriot number 6, Scott Fingerlin. From Phoenix, Arizona, a retired commander in the
Here
United States
they
Navy.
Come.
Baker also served as solo pilot number 5.
What?
Number 6 in Mariner, United States.
Oh, yeah, the T-30. Got it.
As the Patriots approach from Showland, Wilbur will now leave the Delta to only 100 feet. And over 400 miles per hour, ever challenging loop and roll combo.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. Seems my life.
What?
Tears of joy stream down my face.
From show left, Patriot 6. Show right, Patriot 5. Approaching at a closure rate of over 700 miles per hour.
Wow.
As they'll narrowly avoid each other for the Patriots opposing hit.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
was like really good at filming on that part, like for us, and I was like, no, 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 I carried away with that.
Yeah.
I love this song.
Now bleeding the Calypso, the aircraft will shoot skyward and reverse back to show 7 with the trail. Here it is. Approaching from Show Ride, you'll find pictures 2 and 3 about with their red and blue smoke. In preparation for the dust of Jose Gates. Staffs will pull out of the top in a Q&A. Bob Boris will continue to climb over 4,000 feet. Straight up. As he chevrons out of flocks, watch as he'll fly backwards through his own smoke. Fly 1.5 loops, ball towards a good moment of the trail, trying to make that, maintain that 180 degree separation across the circle.
Right in here.
big round of applause for our number four pilot, Paul Sticky Stickman. And that is why we call him Sticky. As Will prepares to climb skyward here shortly, Sticky will turn to inbound to show us the maximum performance turning capability of his L-39. At over 400 miles per hour, Sticky's going up to 6 miles of force of gravity. He's counting on his G-suit to keep the sun from going to his lower extremities to maintain vision. Without a G-suit, it would be almost impossible to maintain control
that
and consciousness throughout this high G demonstration.
Did you see that tight turn
over there?
It's tight.
Overhead. Forge and Stash will then turn a corner away from each other. Yeah. Smoke dog. Jet demonstration team would like to dedicate this heart to everyone who has served this great nation and all those today affected as we mark the 10th anniversary of September 11th, 2001.
Oh, it's making an arrow through the heart.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Show Black Baker, from Show Run Haller, Wilton Foundry Show Center at a closure rate of over 800 miles per hour. Haller's goal, both aircraft will pitch up, nearly missing each other for the imposing inverted eight. But it only girl my heart beats for. I wish that you were mine. Now, anytime she miles in the same area at the same time, well, it's likely to be a little fly contest. Watch the leftist dashless red smoke tries to break his own record for the low level pass.
Oh, God.
Low level pass.
Here inbound from Show Left.
Here he comes.
Dash with red smoke.
Whoa. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
He just stays perfectly straight.
Now it's Forrester with blue smoke. You'll see him bounce to the left. Hitting, excuse me, decreasing his altitude. Hitting that is. See how fast he can take this.
They're one play. On my video camera, it looks like one play.
Yeah.
Adrian, one more now. Direct the other three gets to rejoin.
Good. They're like interlocked.
Back together. Let's watch and see. The motor gets into formation and their smoke system synchronized.
Catch up with each other.
With a diamond coming back together, you'll find Howler closely behind Baker. Bound.
Look at that.
Soon to form the entrail, Clover Loop, and Roll Combo.
If you haven't taken enough videos,
I know. My arm's getting. Just not sure. My lucky star.
The Patriots jet team originated 12 years ago by team owner Randy Howler Howe. The retired United Airlines captain Howler envisioned not just another aerobatic team, but one with high energy and continuous crowd-pleasing aerobatics coupled with maneuvers rarely seen on the airshow circuit. Culminating in over 10 years of thrilling airshow crowds just like all here today, the Patriots marked their 12th year with the addition of two more L-39 aircraft, presenting you with the ever-graceful six-ship Delta formation.
Where's the sixth guy?
He's with them.
Huh?
No.
I don't think so.
Oh, I know. That's only five.
Our next pass is a great opportunity to see all
five. I'm here somewhere. I must be doing something.
L-39 is up close as the pilots maintain a perfect and stable table position. While in big thick formation as they continue inbound. Look high to the right for White Smoke as Big Five will narrowly avoid the formation at the show center point. For the Patriots, Big Vic Hick. The violence of myself enjoyed performing it for the great Airshow crowd such as we have here today. But behind the scenes, the Patriot Jet demonstration team flies thanks to our dedicated group of professionals from our crew chiefs.
The last maneuver by Patriots.
T.
Each other as they cross at the show center point for the bomb burst hit. Using only visual cues, let's see and watch at the Falcon can manage their airspeed and running lines to successfully cross their flight paths with only 50 feet of separation at show center.
What's happening?
Dedicated to inspiring the youth of America, the love of aviation and aerospace, our very own Patriot Jet Team Foundation is a non-profit, all-volunteer group that gives strength today.
And she writes, learning? You learning anything?
Jonathan Sam. Will the parents of Jonathan Sam please report to gate one? Will the parents of Jonathan Sam please report to gate one?
I see an F-18 down there.
Steve Barber flying the F-6F Hellcat is the wing leader of the California SoCal wing in CAF SoCal wing in Camarillo. He founded the Tailhook Legacy Flight in 2000.
Super
Hornet.
Phoenix Sound, 0.95, whatever. Let's see if we can say hi to these guys right now.
He said he's just going to come by and break the sound
barrier.
Highest speed pass.
Okay, you guys call the speeds out. We'll listen, we'll watch, and we're going to be downright impressed.
Come on, man. The highest speed pass.
They will reach speeds of nearly 700 miles per hour. Let's watch.
Super Hornet is the Hornet's new sting for the Navy.
It had its first flight in 1995.
That's so cool.
And it is the younger brother of the Legacy Hornet that's been around since about 1979.
I see propellers.
The original design of the Hornet actually came from an aircraft built by Northrop.
The F-18? No, I think the F-15 is faster.
Able to operate from an aircraft carrier.
I don't think that's a Huey or an Apache.
So the YF-17 built by Northrop, the loser, became a Huey's
Huey
winner for
no,
the United States Navy.
Huey, I think that's a Huey.
Huey's a two-door
Apache.
You're about to watch these two aircraft, the F-6F Hellcat, flown by Steve Barber, the man who flew the first Table Hill Legacy flight. And the United States Navy's F-18 Super Hornet for VFA-122.
It's the oldest.
The commander of the Naval Air Force.
To the newest.
F-18F Super Hornet.
I have 28 minutes of battery left. Oh god! Stay 130! I gotta stop and film this! Oh god! Stay 130! Oh, he's letting out stuff! What is he dropping out the back? Door is open.
It's like ashes or something.
Oh. Maybe it's ashes from 9/11.
Oh.
Damn.
Didn't save. Is he turning around?
No,
I wouldn't even try turning around.
Yeah. It's taking like an hour. Where'd the other planes go? P-38, P-40, P-51, P-51.
They start the 9/11?
And then two F-6Fs.
I'm in it right now.
Oh, there's a P-51 way up there! What's the look?
You do now, do you? That's an engine.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much.
I think it's one of Bruce's.
It's interesting how it's got it in the back.
It's got a rechargeable nose gear. That surprises me.
That's cool.
The elevator's in the front. It's like a total opposite.
Yeah.
Everything's opposite.
Rudder's on the side.
That was interesting.
Just do it.
Stop it, Sydney. That's 16. C5. KC10.
So I wonder why they didn't fly one of those in this thing.
A C5?
Yeah.
I don't know. Steve A.
It's got a red one on the bottom.
Yeah, I know. We're in the water.
Come on, the retracts don't even go inside.
Yeah, I know.
They just go up.
Go on the side of the plane.